Good morning. I'm Sean Canaan with the WMNF News headlines. A couple is fighting a plan for thousands of new homes near their rural neighborhood in Sarasota County. WMNF's Chris Young reports the couple has taken legal action and is awaiting a decision from the courts.
Michael Hutchinson lives in northeastern Sarasota County. His calm, rural neighborhood has horses, very little traffic, and an overall slow pace. But he fears new developments not far away may threaten what makes this area unique.
We're really nervous that when this comes in, it'll change everything for us.
Sarasota County Commissioners approved Lakewood Ranch to build a community of up to 5,000 homes on 4,100 acres near the neighborhood. So Hutchinson and his wife, Eileen Fitzgerald, sued Sarasota County. He says the fight has been happening since last February when Lakewood Ranch presented the idea to county commissioners.
It's a different lifestyle. Living on 5-10 acre parcels is different in a lot of different reasons. A lot of the homeowners that have that property have it for horses. They're into horses one way or another.
A ruling is expected this month. For WMNF News, I'm Chris Young.
Hurricane Lee is whirling through open waters as forecasters warn it could become the first Category 5 storm of the Atlantic season. Lee's projected path takes it near the Northeast Caribbean, but not making landfall. Forecasters say tropical storm conditions are possible on some islands. The storm was located about 965 miles from the northern Leeward Islands today. It had winds of up to 80 miles an hour and was moving to the northwest. Lee was forecast to develop into an extremely dangerous major hurricane by early tomorrow. The heat and humidity are so bad in New York this week that a tennis pro warned that a player could die during the U.S. Open tournament. During his match yesterday, Daniil Medvedev looked into a courtside TV camera in the final set and issued what sounded like a mix between a warning and a plea. He said, "You cannot imagine. One player is going to die and they're going to see." The tournament continues today. Mexico's Supreme Court has thrown out all federal criminal penalties for abortion. The sweeping ruling issued yesterday declared that national laws prohibiting the procedure are unconstitutional and violate women's rights. The decision extended Latin America's trend of widening abortion access. The High Court ordered that abortion be removed from the federal penal code. The decision will require the Federal Public Health Service and all federal institutions in Mexico to offer abortion to anyone who requests it. Rolling Stones are back, and they've brought a few famous friends. The band is releasing Hackney Diamonds, its first album of new songs in 18 years. This is the first single called Angry. Rolling Stones singer Mick Jagger tells reporters they initially considered making an album of songs all about anger, but they figured nobody could be that angry all the time.
I had a second idea, which was not to make it about angry every track. But to make them a bit more eclectic and have a few love songs, ballads, country kind of things. So we've got a mixture.
Jagger says Hackney Diamonds is a slang term stemming from a neighborhood in London.
It's like when you get your windscreen broken on Saturday night in Hackney, all around it, and all the bits go on the street.
Yeah.
Maybe we're a bit too kind of like lazy, and then suddenly we said, well, we go. Let's put a deadline. Let's make a record and put a deadline. So Keith and I and Ronnie had this chat and we said, okay, we'll make this record Christmas and we're going to finish it by Valentine's Day.
The new Stones record features guest appearances from the likes of Lady Gaga, Paul McCartney, and Stevie Wonder. It also features Charlie Watts, the stalwart Stones drummer who died in 2021 after almost six decades in the band. His drumming, recorded in 2019, features on two of the album's dozen tracks. Drummer Steve Jordan plays on the rest. Guitarist Keith Richards says in an AP interview, it was no big deal having Lady Gaga and Stevie Wonder as guest musicians on the Hackney Diamonds album.
We had worked with Lady Gaga before, and we were on the road with Stevie Wonder in the 70s. So, I mean, all of them, nothing new. So come on in, if you've got anything to offer.
I mean, you could say we've been recording, but no, it was hard to keep it all.
Oh, Macca turned up as well. So, yeah, but it was... It just so happened, you know, Andrew Watt, the producer, he's making records with his people, and they just sort of, okay, come on by, you know.
The Stones' new album will release on October 20th. The interest in a Sotheby's auction of Freddie Mercury's personal belongings is so intense that even the cheap stuff is selling way more than estimated. A set of Mercury's chopsticks, estimated to sell for $50, has a bid of $1,500. A silver mustache comb that was expected to sell for $500 has a bid of nearly $44,000. The snake bangle that Mercury wore in the Bohemian Rhapsody video set a record for the highest price paid for a piece of jewelry owned by a rock star. It sold for $881,000, beating out a leather and bead talisman owned by John Lennon. Today it'll be hot with highs in the low 90s. Tonight partly cloudy, overnight lows in the mid-70s. And tomorrow expect scattered thunderstorms with highs near 90. I'm Sean Canaan with the WMNF News headlines.
This is The Scoop, recorded at WMNF Tampa.